So now, the first thing we'll do is we'll copy this, okay, and then we'll just replace this sheet name. Now, we understood how we are going to create sets. So these are some dynamics or dynamic sets. We can go over here and we can create an edit set and we check out how these things are working, right? We can also create some calculated fields as well for the same. Now, the main thing is if we want to create groups now, how we are going to do this? So we are going to select Saturday and we are going to select Sunday, or sorry, Saturday and Sunday. We click on this. I mean, here there should, okay, so there is no such option technically. So yes, so once we select all these points, select this. These are the numbers, okay. So we'll be selecting out Sunday and Saturday. Then there are option of creating sets, okay, and so when we create weekends, it shows only these two things. So in W public, it's not okay. So it is not giving us the option for creating a group. Fine. Let's go. Back to this and let's create a set. Let's exclude, include, add filter to shelf. Let's name it to ASDF. It's just a trial. And yes, okay. Now let's go back to the new sheet. And this new sheet, I'll just okay. I'll take out this and I'll put up this thing here. And I'll select bar chart. Is that workable? No, it's not workable. Fine. So it is not giving me currently an option to create a group technically, because there should be an option over here itself for creating it as a group, and it's aligned together, combined. Create a combined set. Okay, that's not needed actually. Show filters. Right, let's just understand these points. Okay, so let's go back to our presentation, and what we have done is we have created the usage monthly and weekly by transport on every daily basis, and per day, then weekdays and weekends, so we understand it clearly what are the number of travelers, I mean what is the number of travelers who are traveling on weekdays and weekends. Right, now what we can do is per day basis. So instead of day basis, we'll take it into a month basis so that it's look nicer. How we are going to do that? It's very simple. We took a day, we'll convert the same thing into month. So this is the monthly chart. We'll open it, and for this we'll go for week number, right? And then we'll remove the color from it. In the month of December, so there were only these 3 weeks. Sorry, we are going to go with the day. Okay, not this day technically, but we are going for more week weekday, right? So this is how it is going to be visible to us. On every January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. This was the travel scenarios. Now, average counts on the label, right? So on Sunday, it was this. On Monday, it was this. Tuesdays, it was this for each and every month. So this is day-wise, or yes, day-wise, monthly. monthly bus transportation. Okay, and this is how it should look. Now let's just so now we understood all these points. So this is one of the way we can work out. Okay, now if we create a size, we'll be putting up. Okay, the sizes are good. Even tooltips are nice. So this is what we have achieved when we look out for our data: hourly average, monthly, and hourly average bus depots. Okay, so we have covered all these 3 points. So first is the usage of each transportation, weekdays versus weekend. So we have already seen weekdays versus weekend all together as well, and on monthly basis as well, right? So we take it as monthly basis. So let's just change to this to monthly basis. Every month, weekdays and weekends, right? Then there is hourly average traveler, monthly. Okay, let's get back to this and let's select this. Right, so we do have these weekdays and weekend things up here. So if you want only weekends to be shown, every day's weekends are being visible to us, right? Now every day's weekdays are visible to us, isn't it? Yes. So by this is how we are going to. Okay, then now when we put it over here, we can have a condition. So the condition is, so this platform, what we are seeing, or this this dialogue, what we are seeing, it's for this thing. If we select it, so this is the average count. We are not checking out the average count, but we are again checking out the charges. So not only charges, but let's say we want to check out the number of starting journey is equals to, sorry, not starting journey, but charges is less than, sorry, its charges is less than 30. So only those things need to be displayed. So there is nothing, no such charges available. Let's go back and let's edit filter. Let's take greater than 30. Okay, so this was charge and sum of charges is greater than 30. Everyone was 30. Let's take it 500. Yes, so everyone has this charge, sum of charges 100. So let's put up this thing on label and we'll check. It has charge of 230. This one has charge of 450. Okay, so now if you want to check out the number of charges with it, we'll go back, edit filter. So we are just checking out the charges who have less than 500. So let's go for an average, or let's go for the sum again. And well, this time instead of here, we are going to provide values to here. So this is the minimum and this is the maximum value. And apply. And over here, we are going to provide 250. Charges are less than 250. Okay, nothing. So that gives us some or the other hint that how we are going to use these points over here. Average count is 1. It's less than 1. Sorry, less than 2. There's nothing which has less than 2. Less than 3. Yes. So these are the counts which have less than 3. We'll remove this sum of charges. Yes. So these are the counts who are less than 3. Charges are less than 3. But is it correct? It is correctly displaying every. So this is just for weekends technically. What about weekdays? We'll put up the same condition of weekdays as well. Condition: week average count custom is less than 3. Okay, it is equals to, let's say, 2. Is there anything? No. Let's go for 3. No, but when we select up, your average count is less than 3. Yes, If we select the other one, yes. But what is this? Now, average count over here is not being displayed properly, right? It is showing me 1.67 is my average count, whereas the condition which I have put in over here doesn't work with it. Do it. So what does this mean? Average count is greater than 3. So let's put it greater or equals to 3. There are some points, right? So it's showing for only Mondays and Fridays, Mondays and Fridays. Let's remove this Friday. Apply. Only Mondays then. Let's go for charges. Charges is greater or equals to 500. Apply. Click it OK and let's go for charges and label them 455. So it is showing all the weekdays, but keeping in loop of in and out, in once, okay, sorry, out once then. So this is how it is being displayed. I mean, this is how you are going to set your conditions on the different sets.